from rags to riches, but it wasn't luck.
30 years ago, Glenn Stearns started with nothing and built a billion-dollar lending company, one of the largest in the country. Glenn is betting $1 million of his own money that he can take $100 and grow it into a $1 million business in just 90 days.
But I understand that I get treated differently because I'm wealthy. So, to keep this experiment fair, I'm gonna do it all undercover. I won't use my name, my money, or my connection.
That is so cool. Listen, not everybody gets to be a billionaire, but just good sound advice, right?
Gonna try, yes.
Gonna try. Okay, so we have a little B-roll. If he looks super familiar, you guys all saw him in audience holding. One of your tips was kind of how to make a buck, and he tried to make a buck off some of you guys, right? Oh, God, you put my name on it? Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord.
Well, you know what it is, I tell you what. I mean, the first tip has to do with demand, right?
Right.
Which is basically, you know, find your audience. Know who you have that you can sell to. A lot of times we have something that we think is great, but the reality is no one else thinks it's great, right?
Right.
But go to where people have a demand. In this case, I mean, think about it, right? You've got this wonderful audience. You got people
and
here
that... And they sit online to come here, so why not buy something with
my name
on it or something?
I look at you, what you did, right? You took the 30-minute meal because you looked out at the people going, I want pizza. I want something
right,
fast in 30
minutes. Right,
I want pizza
delivered in 30 minutes or less, so you might be willing to spend... That was exactly it. You might be willing to spend 30 minutes to make dinner.
That's right.
Right.
I mean, we made $250 in less than a half an hour.
It's pretty good.
We did pretty good.
Although...
Here's your money.
Let me be epically clear. I'm sorry, and you are getting your money back. And everyone that made those for us at Personalization Mall that gifted us those cups for his experiment, of course, sent enough for the whole class, and you could all have one for free.
There you go. But I tell you also, I think what's important is, you know, you get out there and you want to start a business, and people go, I'm lost. How do I get started? And there are resources out there all across the country. There's a great one called the Small Business Development Center where people can go in. I mean, it's paid by our tax dollars. So you go in, they'll help you with office space. They'll help you really get your product going.
And it's something we've already prepaid for as a country. I didn't even know that. That's so great.
That's right. I mean, it's out there.
Like a baby business school.
Absolutely.
Okay, next tip.
Well, next tip has to do with really basically buying low and selling high, right?
Right.
I mean, it's about really finding something that has some margin in it. What I did was go out and sell cars on the show because it's fast and you can go do really well. People go and they turn in these wonderful cars into car dealers when they trade them in, but they might have too many miles. So what the car dealer do is he'll usually take those and he'll send them to an auction. Well, you should go up to that car dealer and say, can I buy that car? Or get the license yourself and go to the auction. I mean, I bought one for $700, turned around and sold it for more than $3,500.
Wow.
You know, and then that was a Honda. Then I took the Escalade from that money, bought that for $1,500 and made, I think, $7,000 or over that.
So great.
We go in and get it and try to do it. And I mean, it's actually a wonderful idea. Anybody can do that out there really quickly. I took all that and bought a house then, this is part of the show, and flipped that, turned around. That didn't work out as well as the cars did.
But, it's not all foolproof, kids.
That's right.
Okay, coincide with another tip?
So actually, my third tip is, I mean, when you're busy, when you're out there doing a business, you know, a lot of people put it, their calendar items or something. I always forget about that. I put in my actual alarms, right? All my alarms.
Oh.
And I want to be reminded. If I'm talking to you,
right,
my alarm goes off and it says, oh, I gotta
call. I gotta go do this. Right.
And so I keep it going, or else at least I snooze it and not forget about it. People get so, you know, they get really frustrated with me, but I won't let it go because I have to do that. You know,
and it really depends on your personality. If you're someone that at the end of the day, over and over again, you say to yourself, I can't believe I forgot to do that again. That's so simple, but it's
right.
So pure. And you can just have it on vibrate. Like, my phone just goes,
Yeah,
like,
that's mine.
Hey, yeah, exactly.
Remember, and at the end of the day, you really want to get things done.
Love you, baby. So Glenn is amazing. And if you want to spend more time with Glenn, you can watch his show, Undercover Billionaire. It's Tuesdays at 10 p.m. on one of the coolest channels on the planet, Discovery.